Happy Wednesday and welcome to Nashville's weekly update with the amazing Burnett Group team. As always, it's so great to see Matt and Marty. They have incredible information every week to empower you in homeownership, understanding real estate, investing, and everything that goes along with having a piece of that American dream. Great to see you guys again this week.
Good to see you.
I'm a little sad that I'm sitting in the other seat again today and not next to you. Last week was so wonderful, but we're going to jump into our topic today because we're going to talk about home staging, which is so much fun. It is so much fun when you see a home that's really staged well and like, wow, it makes all the difference versus a home that's cluttery. Let's talk about what you see and why it makes a difference and what your advice is on that.
Yeah, staging is, it's a part of what we do and I love it. Not all agents stage, actually most of them don't. There's just a handful of us that do that. I am a firm believer in staging from when I first started in the industry, but I think it's fun. A lot of people don't buy into staging. They don't understand it. No offense, but sometimes my men are the ones that when I start telling them what we need to do to prep to sell, they're like,
are you sounds like a lot more work, but.
It is a lot more work. But my deal is if you're moving, you got to pack and get organized anyway. So the staging has two pieces to it, right? It has the decluttering and then, and that piece and getting ready for the move. But then it also has the piece that is, making it most appealing to buyers.
Sure.
And both pieces resonate to maximizing profits or not. So I'm always like, it's your choice. If you don't want it to bring as much money as it possibly can, let's don't stage. But if you do, then, staging is probably a good idea.
Well, what do you advise when there's people out there saying, but this is, multiple offer, this is a seller's world right now. So how do you advise when they say, well, I don't need to because we're going to get multiple offers?
Well, it's interesting because I've even had agents go, you're still staging stuff? Like, are you serious? And I'm like, yeah, it's what I do. Yes, the market is it's a seller's market. It's doing well, but there's still a margin there as to what your house will bring, staged versus unstaged. The average that you can find online will say about 10% that your staged properties, your staged and professionally photographed properties will bring 10% more than not staged and not professionally photographed. So, with that being said, that pays for all of the seller's cost. Plus, it puts several more percentages in their pockets. So it makes sense. I mean, even in a multiple offer market. So let's say, are you going to get a better offer if you get two buyers or if you get 10? I mean, the likelihood is that with the 10 buyers, so staged and professionally photographed, you're going to get more attraction, which is a higher likelihood that you'll get.
You got to get them to the property before they can make an offer.
Right.
And so that helps get them, they help see it online in the pictures and they can place their stuff in their own head without having to worry about that because they already see it.
Well, yeah, walk for us through the process. So what does that look like? You've just taken the listing. You say, hey, we're going to stage your home. Do they panic? Like, what are you going to do with my stuff? Walk through the process.
Yeah, the husbands freak out a lot. The wives most of the time think, oh, this is going to be fun. The first stage of it is really a declutter. And a lot of times people will do that before we come to actually the staging. And then sometimes the staging is in two or three stages. It just, phases depending on where someone is. So most of the time I can tell them just over the phone, go ahead and take down personal photos, personal pictures, declutter closets. If you're not taking it with you on the move, go ahead and get rid of it, sell it, whatever you're going to do. So that when I come there, we've got minimal.
Okay.
You start, and I try to tell them with my experience with buyers, Matt and I've been working with buyers and sellers for, 16
years,
20 years. Yeah, I know. 20 years for Matt, 16 for me. And it's a process. So I start from the beginning. Typically, if we can, we'll start from outside and I'll say, okay, so when a buyer is coming to your house, this is what they see. They're looking for your house by your mailbox. Mm-hmm. That's how they're going to find it. Your address. If the numbers are hanging off or crumbly or not there at all, they're past the house. They got to turn around. They got to come back. They're already frustrated by the time they pull into your driveway.
Right.
So that we've already set a negative tone. So I start at the mailbox, honestly. And then we work our way as a buyer, pulling into the driveway, walking up the stairs. Are there weeds in the flower beds? Did you pressure wash the driveway? Things like that. So we kind of
clear the cobwebs.
Yeah, yeah. We go through all of those steps from the outside. Then we move into the inside. If they've already done the decluttering, then we're tweaking, and I'm tagging things that need to be stored or removed, you know, because they're too big for the spaces or whatever. We're not I tell people staging is undecorating. You know, it's the total opposite of decorating. It's undecorating. And that's where they get thrown off. They're, you know, it's a lot of people, oh, you don't like my decor. And it has nothing to do with your decor or anything like that. It's just about setting the stage for the buyer. We want to neutralize and depersonalize.
Because the buyer wants to visualize their own stuff in there, don't they?
They do.
Yeah, I'll say, yeah, they do. But at the same time, it's a lot easier to see properly staged stuff in a room. They can walk in and see how it lays out without having to try and think about, is this room really big enough for my stuff?
Right, right.
It's funny how that works. An empty house doesn't sell as well as a staged house.
Right.
I mean, you can take a room and somebody come into it overfilled with stuff. Oh, this room just feels so small. And, you know, I try to point out, well, they've got gigantic furniture, you know, when I'm working with buyers. But on the seller end, I'm like, you've got gigantic furniture. Like, it makes the room look small. And a lot of times they will understand that, because the way you stage a house is not necessarily the way that you'll live in. And everybody lives in a space differently. So you do want them to be able to visualize their things in there. That's why you don't want a certain type of decor. And it doesn't mean that your decor is good or bad. It's just, it needs to be more neutral. And I use the example, why do you think these builders spend all this money with these, you know, putting together these model homes? Because they work, you know, mm-hmm. So we're creating a model home feel. Nobody lives in a model home. Like, they just don't. So, you know, trying to explain to them why this works. Some people get it really quickly. Some people say, I don't care. I trust you. If you say it's going to make me more money, I'll stand on my head in the corner for an hour and not ask you questions. And then I got the ones that give me pushback. And, you know, I just tell them, you just choose. Like, you either want to do it and make all the money, or you're okay not making all the money, or you're okay getting less offers and, you know, or maybe not going into the multiple offers. So there's all these different things that we go through with that.
Do you find that once you go into the process, most people really take your advice and they get it and see it? Or do you feel like sometimes you're pushing it all the way through? Like, okay, come on, this is going to work. This is going to work. What do you see the normal reaction is as you start to really work with somebody? Because people get attached to their things, like you said, like, hey, you don't like my decorating. But how do you see that transformation take place as you start to work with people?
Well, for me, most of the time they cuss me as they're doing it, they're calling things off, they're getting storage built, and they're like, and I've had clients even say, Marty, we cussed you the whole way through this. But then once it goes under contract so quickly and they're looking around going, we got to be out of here in X number of days, then they're like, we get it.
So
at that point they're thanking me, like, thank you for having us get all that crap out of here, because we're not moving anything we don't need. Plus it simplifies their move. Wildly. I've never in, knocking on wood here, I've never in 16, almost 17 years of doing this, had anybody look at me and go, I can't believe we did all that. It didn't work. Never.
Oh,
never.
See, there's the testimony right there. And this is why you guys are such top professionals. You guys really, this is what we talk about, going the extra mile. You are going the extra mile, because you're the ones really going in and saying, hey, this is what needs to be done. A lot of agents do not take the steps that you guys are taking to make this kind of a difference, because you're right, it's twofold. Not only is it helping maximize their dollars for the sale of the home, but really you're helping them organize their move, and they're going to be a lot happier in the new place that they got their stuff in order. Like, well, that's a whole other thing right there.
Yeah, there's a lot that happens between that contract to close, and you don't need the haggle and hassle of garage sales and cleaning out closets. Like, do that before the buyer gets involved. Like,
right.
It makes sense on so many levels, but, you know, a lot of people, it's a lot of work. I mean, it's a lot of work on my part. They got to do the work regardless. It's just, do we do the work in a fashion where you have control of the time frame, or do we do it in a shuck and run type mode? And I very rarely have my clients say that we had trouble getting out towards the end because they're already prepared. Another thing that we do is on vacant houses, we stage all our vacant houses as well. We have two or three trailers. I've got
several sets of furniture. It doesn't have to be 100%, you know, dressed out, but just enough to give everybody a really good idea, very comfortable feeling of what it looks like and what how they could live there makes a big difference.
Yeah, a vacant house, a lot of times people go in, and even in a vacant house, oh, God, this room seems so small. I don't have a king-size bed will fit in here. But if I've staged it with a queen-size bed, two end tables, and, you know, little artwork and some tchotchkes, all of a sudden that they question never comes up.
I mean, it's brilliant.
It's so strange how I can make these houses. I bring my house stretcher and I stretch these rooms and shrink that, you know, they shrink down and stretch out. It's just, it's a spatial awareness for people, you know, and a lot of times they'll come into a kitchen, especially if it's an eat-in, and it's like, where do you put your table? But, you know, if I've got a table already in there, you know, set and looking cute, question never comes up. So yeah, like Matt says, I don't stage every single room, but we usually stage like the living room, the kitchens, the bathrooms and the master bedroom, you know, just it's a spatial
those
awareness.
Main spaces.
Yeah. The main spaces. So we've got several sets of furniture. We've got a storage unit where, or a storage barn where we keep everything. And yeah. So, I get, you know, we do vacant houses as well, because I mean, these vacant houses, what are you professionally photographing in a vacant house? A bunch of vacant rooms.
Yeah. Walls.
Yeah, exactly. But it's a spatial awareness for people. So it works really, really well. So we do that. That's something we do as well. And there's very, very, very few agents that I know of do that at all. So
what you guys are doing is just brilliant, doing that extra service for your clients. And it goes back to something we talked about weeks ago about, you know, preparing for selling your home in the spring or the summer, starting ahead. What you guys are doing is showing another step of how you're saying, prepare. Don't just call me and say, I want to list my home tomorrow. These are incredible steps that they can take to be doing to maximize their dollars and have a better experience. You're walking them through a better experience, because so many people say, oh, selling my house and moving, this was just, you know, such a hard thing. You guys are literally taking the hard parts of that off of them. And then you're brilliant for doing that. And I hope that most real estate professionals really start to take wind and do that as well, because it's what's best for the client. But you guys are there handling, you know, the greater Nashville area. This is what you're doing for your clients and why you're the best that there is out there. And I'm just so glad that I get to hear all of these things and these ideas that you guys do and see the results. And if I encourage everybody, follow them on social media. First of all, they are a riot. They are the best couple out there. They've got a busy life, busy kids, but there is nothing that they don't do for their clients, and an incredible resource. Thank you so much for sharing this awesome information today.
No problem. Absolutely. Yeah, it's our pleasure. I mean, moving is stressful, and we tell people all the time, moving stressful, it just is. So our job is just to simplify it for you. And if you call us and let us get involved in your process before it starts, we will ensure that we will do our best to make it as seamless and minimally stressful as possible. It's just moving is, it's crazy, but we do crazy. And so we know how to minimize that stress there for you.
You guys are the masters of doing crazy and making it look excellent. Mm-hmm. Minimizing stress. There you have it. Thank you so much. What a great EXP Nashville weekly update with the Burnett Group. Great to see you guys as always.
Thank you so much.
Thanks, Amy.